Now, I was thinking, well, what could we get our potassium superoxide to react with? It's seen it reacting with water, but it should be able to. It's got all this oxygen, surplus of oxygen. What could it react with? And when I was putting the lecture together, I thought, well, what should we have it react with? And there's all sorts of different possibilities. I thought, well, what would be nice would be to have it react with one of the other alkali metals, one of the other group 1 metals. So, of course, lithium really wants oxygen. Potassium superoxide has more than enough oxygen to spare. So maybe if we mix the two together, we should be able to get a nice reaction. OK, this is the potassium superoxide, the yellow potassium superoxide added to the lithium. OK, I think I'll just give this a bit of a stir. Just make sure they're all nicely mixed up together. Now, when we tried this, I didn't know whether this was going to work. I thought, well, it ought to. I mean, chemistry says that, the lithium wants lots of oxygen. The potassium has more than enough to spare here. So it ought to react. We'll just give it a drop of water. So in the same way we started the reaction with the Rice Krispies and the sodium peroxide, we can start this reaction with a drop of water. It just allows everything to mix nicely. So add a drop. There we are. And if we have the lights down, please. Maybe we can see a reaction take place. Well, it's caught fire. That's a good sign. And the lithium is now burning in the oxygen produced by the potassium superoxide. So this brilliant white light is the lithium here reacting very, very quickly, very vigorously with the oxygen. So a very violent reaction. Actually, when we first tried this, we accidentally destroyed the fume cupboard. involved lots of paperwork. Yes. So we've scaled it down a little bit here. But there we are. Okay.